Hello everyone, we are going to discuss question number 53 from MTP 4. Here, heat of combustion of ethylene is given to us and it's given that it's 70% efficient. So, we have to calculate the amount of water that can be converted into steam at 100 degrees Celsius by burning 1 meter cube of ethylene at STP. Specific heat and latent heat of vaporization of water is also given. So first of all, we will calculate the number of moles present in 1 meter cube of ethylene. 1 meter cube means 1000 liter of ethylene. So the number of moles will be 1000 divided by 22.4 moles. Now, the enthalpy change due to burning of 1 meter cube of ethylene will be equal to enthalpy of combustion multiplied by number of moles, so that will come out to be minus 337 into 1000 divided by 22.4 kilocalorie. As it's given that it's 70% efficient, so the useful heat out of the total heat will be equal to 70% of the heat that we have obtained in the previous step. Now to convert H2O from liquid to gas, there are two stages. First, we need to heat it from 20 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius, and then we need to provide extra additional heat in order to change its phase. So, in order to increase its temperature from 20 to 100 degrees Celsius, we need to provide specific heat according to the specific heat, and in order to change its phase we need to provide latent heat of vaporization. Specific heat is given 80 calorie per kilogram, that means 80 kilocalorie are required to heat the water from 20 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. Now, the total enthalpy required to convert water at 20 degrees Celsius to water or steam at 100 degrees Celsius will be equal to 80 plus 540 kilocalorie per kilogram. That will be equal to 620 kilocalorie per kilogram. So the total water that is converted into steam, that will be equal to the total heat that's been evolved divided by the heat that is required to convert 1 kilogram of water into steam. So substituting all the required values from the data we have obtained, we will get the amount of water that is converted into steam will be 16.98 kilogram. Hello everyone, we are going to discuss question number 54 from MTP4. So in this question, it's given that a sample which contains sodium carbonate as well as sodium sulfate. When we dissolve 1.5 gram of the sample and make its volume as 250 ml, and then 25 ml of this solution is taken, which requires 20 ml of decinormal solution of H2SO4 for neutralization. So we have to find out the percentage of sodium carbonate in the sample. Now, as you know that sodium carbonate is the only element that will react here with H2SO4. So that means they will have equal number of equivalents, that is N1V1 equal to N2V2. So N1V1 for sodium carbonate will be equal to N2V2 for H2SO4. Let's suppose sodium carbonate have N1 normality multiplied by its volume is 25 ml, and that will be equal to normality of H2SO4, that is 1 by 10 multiplied by its volume, that is 20 ml. So from here we will get the normality of sodium carbonate solution, that is 0.08. Now we can also calculate the equivalent mass of sodium carbonate as its molar mass divided by 2. So that will come out to be 53. Now we have to find out the mass of Na2CO3 as We are required to find out the percentage, so first we will need to find out the mass of Na2CO3 present. So the mass of Na2CO3 present will be equal to normality multiplied by equivalent weight multiplied by volume divided by 1000. Substituting all the values as 0.08 into 53 into 250 divided by 1000, we will get the mass of Na2CO3 as 1.06 gram. So percentage of Na2CO3 will be equal to its mass divided by total mass multiplied by 100. So that will come out to be 1.06 divided by 1.50 multiplied by 100. So that is 70.67%. Hello everyone, we are going to discuss question number 55 from MTP4. Here, density of NaCl is given and its molar mass is also given. It's given to us that the first order reflection maximum for the X-rays from 200 planes of NaCl occur at the angle 5.9 degree. So we have to find out the wavelength of X radiations in angstrom. In order to find out the wavelength, we will apply Bragg's law, or we can say Bragg's equation, but there also we have to have the value of interplanar distance, that is the value of d. So first of all, we will calculate the interplanar distance, that is d, using the provided data, that is density and the molecular mass of the compound. So interplanar distance is given as m divided by 2 into Avogadro number into density whole raised power 1/3. Substituting all the values, we will get the interplanar distance is 2.82 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter, or 2.82 angstrom. Now as we have the value of d, that is interplanar distance, we can use the x equation. Value of n will be 1, as it is the first order reflection, multiplied by lambda, equal to 2 into d into sine of theta, that is 5.9. Substituting all the values, we will get the value of wavelength, or lambda, is 0.579 angstrom.